guys, welcome back to my channel. Okay, so today I was like, okay, what do I want to talk to the people about, or like, what do I want to say? But today I really wanted to just share my quiet time, which quiet time, for those of you who don't know, is just time with God in the morning. Like, literally, it's how I spend my time with God, in prayer and just reading the word. And so this morning I was like, you know what, I'm gonna have a quiet time where I have coffee with God, like, and go sit outside and like just be in nature and really just, you know, like be in this space with God. This, like, almost like an ideal date, just like get up, grab coffee. Actually, it's like one of my movie, like my whole movie scenes in my head, like one of those scenes where you wake up and you're in New York and you go to your favorite coffee shop and grab a cup of coffee and you're just like, there's like theme music playing in the background. Anyways, that's just kind of like what I wanted to do with God this morning, so I did. And I'm reading the book of Ezekiel, and it's been very interesting because there's a lot going on. There's a lot I didn't understand, and you know, you have these four figures with four faces, and they have wings, and there's a wheel underneath them, and it's just like this picture that's being painted right from the jump. And I'm like, wait, how? What's visually going on? But yeah, this is all happening. And so, you know, Ezekiel's his prophet, and God has basically chosen him to speak to the people, and all of this stuff is going on, and Ezekiel's like prophesying all these different things that are happening to these different nations, just because of the wickedness that was happening. And so after all of that has happened, now I'm reading in chapter 33, and I finally had a moment where, like, a just like clarity of like where I, all of a sudden I was like zeroed in and focused, and I was like, I knew what's going on or what's being said. And it was when I started reading verse 10, it just kind of, this verse really stood out to me. It just kind of jumped out. And in verse 10 in the NIV, in the NIV version, Ezekiel, I think, is the one who is addressed as the Son of Man. And so God's talking to Ezekiel, and he says, Son of Man, say to the Israelites, this is what you are saying. Our offenses and our sins weigh us down, and we are wasting away because of them. And I was just like, whoa, our offenses and our sins weigh us down, and because of that, we're wasting away. And it made me just really think of, what are the things that can make that I allow myself to waste away? And especially in this time of the year when the holidays start to approach, and, you know, we see people spending time with family, we see people posting, you know, new relationships, or just even friends that we know in the past who are like getting married, having kids. I know for me, I can become in this place where I start to idolize what other people have. I can be envious. I can be jealous. And it affects my mood, and it puts me in this place where I'm depressed. You know, it puts me in this place where I start to think of all the things I'm not doing or haven't done. And literally, you know, when that happens, I don't really make the connection of how, what, like, the things I've done in my life to end up there. You know, I don't spend enough time reflecting on the decisions I've made in my life, my sin, or the offenses I've caused others. And I get so stuck on the, why is this my life? Why is this happening to me? You know, why didn't I do better? And, you know, all these things. But ultimately, I just let time pass as I waste away in those thoughts and those ideas and those, and it's just another trap. It's another mental trap. And so reading this today just kind of was like, wow, that's what that's doing. And And I like that after that, you know, there's a short little paragraph of where God's just talking about, like, he doesn't take pleasure in seeing people die. He doesn't take pleasure in any of that. And all he really wants is for those that were wicked in the scripture and what was going on in Ezekiel. He just wanted them to turn away from that. You know, he just wanted them to turn from the decisions and the choices that they were making and turn away from their evil ways. And then he opposes this question. God just says, why will you die, people of Israel? And I think that, like, I'm thinking about that. I'm just like, wow, why would we choose death? Why do I choose death? Or why do I put myself in that position instead of really... you know that there's another option. I don't have to die this kind of death. And it's a really good question for us to ask ourselves, especially when we like fall into these thought process or these just depressive states, or just where we only think of like, why is this happening to me? Kind of thought. And so, you know, it made me really realize I don't spend enough time reflecting on the decisions I've made to put myself where I'm at. Therefore, I get to this place of like, why me? Why me? Instead of being like, wow, maybe you made some poor decisions in your life. And because of your poor decisions, you ended up in these places. And not to really condemn myself, because that can be even depressing, but I have to accept the responsibility that came with the choices I made to really move forward, to really excel and not end up there again. And so this really just kind of helped me see that today, this morning. I was like, wow, I have to change my thinking in this sense and really allow that to even change my actions and what I do so that I'm not putting myself in the same position, you know, and this calls for changing my life. This calls for me to not only talk about the things that I want to see change, but the action behind them. You know, like when you're comparing your life and you allow jealousy and envious thoughts to come in, that's sin. And so again, that's that, like, we can take light of those things because we can just see it as, oh, I'm just like, just sad. I'm just happy for that person, and neglect that. No, it's really sin that's sitting there. You know, there's a lot more that's buried underneath that that you haven't really gone through or really sat through in it. And at this point in my life, I'm realizing that as well. And so, I just share this because all of this didn't happen until I met, some incredible women who are in my life who literally just asked me if I wanted to study the Bible. And was like, hey, have you ever studied the Bible? And I thought to myself, I've never studied the Bible. Why not? Like, I've never actually tried to with a heart that wants to. It was more of just like, I knew what the Bible was. I think as a teenager, I tried to do, but I wasn't into it and I didn't really understand. But as an adult, I was like, you know what? Let me do that. And so if you are interested in studying the Bible, if you just want to see change in your life, study the Bible. If you want to grow, study the Bible. And so yeah, if you want to study the Bible, please click on the links below. My Instagram is on there, my Facebook. And just reach out, even in the comments below, reach out. And I'd love to get in touch with you. And I would love to share more about my life with you and just kind of, you know, the deep waters of my heart, because the truth is there's still a lot about myself I'm learning. I don't know everything. There's still a lot that I need to learn, but I am learning that, you know, my heart is something that God wants. And so I can't try to own any rights to it. And God really shows his heart by just, you know, even in that passage there, by saying, like, he doesn't want the wicked to die. He doesn't want people actually to die at all. He just wants us to turn from our ways, and we just have to be willing to. And that's gonna take some action on our part. And so, yeah, I just wanted to share that with you guys. stay tuned for more stuff. And yeah, I can't wait to see what this channel, like what God does with this channel, whatever, you know. And if you just want to learn about your deep waters, the deep waters of your heart, girl, gentlemen, this is what I'm saying. All right, I love you guys. That just flew out everywhere. But also, be safe. COVID is real, y'all. It's out there. Be safe. Protect yourself. Love your families. Eat good food. Exercise. And try not to oversleep. I'm preaching to myself with that one, too. There is something else I wanted to say before saying goodbye, but I think that's it. So, see you guys next time. Be like deep waters, gotta dive in. I don't know what should I do for deep waters has in store for my life and whoever life's come along with my life. I don't know. But yeah, that's that. And because my eyebrows are, when they're arched like this, I can't do the rock eye properly, like, you know. I don't know, they both, okay, but that looks more questionable versus like that intense eyebrow that just, there you go, like that raises, like, I can't do it with this one though. Oh, I guess I can. I can't think about it. It just has to happen. All right, I'm done.